Something I want to touch on quick. In this video, I do a before pull and an after pull and show you the differences on our programming versus how the vehicle showed up. You'll notice in the other videos, I don't typically do that. The majority of the time, that's for one of two reasons. First reason being that I just don't think about it. The customer doesn't ask for it. So we kind of just move through the process. We're able to get the job done a little quicker. Obviously, it doesn't take a lot to do a pull, but that's the first reason. The second reason, the majority of vehicles we get here are not ready to be put through their paces. They're new builds, they're fresh, they haven't had a program in them for the setup that's in there, and it's just not safe to push them through their paces when they first show up. So I thought I'd explain that, why this one I did a before and after, and the other videos I typically don't. That is the two reasons that are most popular as to why that is. So check this thing out. We made some pretty decent gains with this car. For what it is, it was a decent number. We're happy with it. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. All right, here's our tune for today. It's an 01 Mustang, just a two valve, naturally aspirated. It's got some fuel system stuff done to it. It's got a different intake manifold. This one's all aluminum. I'm really not sure what manifold that is. You know, your cold air intake stuff. Your basic bolt-ons, it's got headers, exhaust. I believe this thing has a small set of cams in it, but they don't know what the cams were. This is mostly a street slash track day car. It's got a cage in it, stereo system. It's neat. I like the paint. I like the orange on the black. It looks cool, two-tone, something a little different. It's got this decaled stripe up here. That's kind of cool looking. But yeah, these things, stock stick shift two valve cars, typically make in the 212 220 area. We'll see what this makes. I'm expecting it to make 260 to 280, somewhere in that area. But neat little car. I do like these new edges. My dad's got a single turbo one that it's like 600 wheel that he drives all the time, and it's just a fun car. They're neat. They look good. But I'm gonna get rolling on tuning this thing and keep you guys in the loop. See what it makes. I did something I don't always do, but sometimes I did a before hit. The customer was saying he thought the car was really rich, and I was just curious. So this thing made 258, 265. But the wideband reading down here on the bottom there, it's mid nines the whole pull. So he was right. It's definitely rich. You'll hear in the video that I hit it on the limiter a bit. It was still pretty flat out there. We could turn it a little bit harder. But just to give you guys an idea of a little bit before and after, I'll get tuning some fuel out of this thing. I think what happened is somebody had changed the injectors, and then it was never tuned for them. It starts that way. It's loaded up with fuel just in cranking, and the richness at full throttle, obviously. So thought that was kind of just something I wanted to share. So I'll keep going. We're able to gain like 28 horsepower on this naturally aspirated 4.6. not only because it was very rich, as I talked in the first video, but also I believe it had too much timing in it. This thing didn't want a lot of timing. It wanted 20 degrees at 6,000, which is pretty low for naturally aspirated two valve. They're typically on 93, 24 or so. And without it being tuned on a dyno, you know, they wouldn't have known that, right? So, so here's the graph. From now, I'm gonna open the before one real quick so you can get it. Let me just move this so you can see it a little better. I'll open the before one real fast here. It's all jagged like that because it didn't complete the pull because the limiter was set very well. I'll set it to scatter graph. So that's the difference between the two. I, again, lean the thing out quite a bit. When I'm just pulling the fuel away and leaving the timing in it, that was, you know, on the base map, which was 23 degrees up top. It made 270, removing 273, I think. Removing the timing was actually worth like 11 horsepower. But yeah, pretty significant change for a naturally aspirated two-valve deal. So it's ready to go. I'm going to get off here and call these guys.